Now for the front, the pattern says to follow steps 1 and 2 for the back. And then the armhole, mark the row for both ends of the armhole. Now this sweater is basically the drop shoulder. I didn't do the raglan on this, but I wanted to just show how to do the round neck if you wanted to do that instead of a V-neck. So this one here says to, of course, you get up to 80 rows, and then thread the center 12 stitches. So I have the 12 stitches. I could go ahead with my double-eyed needle and one by one push the needle back and pull the waist yarn through that, or I could go underneath and go into each loop, pull the needle back. It's really up to you which way you want to do this. And this way here, I don't have to do 6 rows of waist yarn on this one. And I could also do it for the shoulders as well. And of course, you get so far, you could pull it through. But sometimes it's just as easy to do one at a time. Now, normally you get this double-eyed needle when you get a ribber, but you could buy them if you do not have that tool. Okay, so now I need to basically do the same as before, but I'm going to be doing more decreasing. I'm going to take the cast-on comb off. I'm going to hang my weights on the edge of the work. Put my carriage, my Russell levers out to hold, so it's not going to knit these stitches. And the other thing is, it tells you how many rows you're at. So when you go back to this side here, you're going to reset your counter back to whatever row you started this with. Now, if that's not enough weight, you could go ahead and put some more claw weights on so it holds it all down. So now shaping this one here. Okay, I have 25 stitches this time instead of 21, but I'm still going to get down to the 19 stitches. So decrease one stitch, neck edge, every row 6 times until 19 stitches remain. Work 10 rows even. Now, this is pretty easy. I have seen some other patterns that are every other row. But again, I'm going to take my two-prong transfer tool. And I have to remember to keep those stitches into work position. If I pull it out there, the carriage won't knit it. So if I pull it out, I have to put them back to the forward working position. Knit across. Two. Three, four, five, six. So let's see. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So yeah, I have the 19 stitches on. So I'm just going to knit 10 rows. That would have been the decrease. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And it looks like part of my stitch there got caught on the gate peg here. So I could go ahead and pull it up and there, drop down. If it's a long loop there, I'll just have to pull it from the back side here. So now, I think this is the side that I need to graft. Let's see. That's a long one. So no, I have to do over here. I don't have enough on this side. So on this side here, I'm going to have to leave the long end. You only need it on one side. You don't need it on both front and back. So I'm going to cut that. Work up rows of waist yarn, and I'm going to move my claw weights up here a bit, just two of them. Take the third one off. Cut the waist yarn. Remove the claw weights. Actually, I should move them over here. And I can take that clip off there. Knit across to release these stitches. Come back. I'm going to push those needles to non-working position. I'm going to put my carriage back so it's going to knit these stitches. But I need to, again, do that decrease on the first row like I did the other side. Then, of course, when you're done, we're going to get to the neckband.